الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على خاتم النبيين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا. اللهم ربنا زدنا علما. Dear brothers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. The thanks more and more should be announced for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator and sustainer of this universe, the one who subhanahu wa ta'ala given us all and every grace we are having. Just when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the help and the possibility to gather in one masjid to discuss his deen, this will come under the hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is narrated by Muslim, that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَجْتَمَعَ قَوْمٌ فِي بَيْتٍ مِّن بُيُوتِ اللَّهِ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَيَتَدَارَسُونَهُ بَيْنَهُمْ إِلَّا حَفَّتْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَغَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةُ وَتَنَزَّلَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ السَّكِينَةُ وَذَكَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنْ عِنْدَهُ. All these graces are from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those people who are spending some of their time to talk about Al-Quran and Al-Sunnah. Continuing what we have started before, we are going to talk tonight also inshallah about one more contradiction of Islam. That after we remember that the sequence of our dars, the sequence of our dars, we started to talk about the hadith of Jibreel alayhi salam, which is talking about the pillars of Islam and the pillars of Iman and the pillar of Ihsan and so on. And we started to talk about the pillars of Islam by talking about the first pillar, which is the Shahadatayn. And we started to talk about the importance of Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah. And we said that Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah will not be beneficial to anybody unless it contains three conditions, that to know the meaning of it, to practice it in life, and to refrain or to be free from falling into the contradictions of it. And we started to talk about the contradictions of La ilaha illallah. And we said that the first contradiction, which is one of the 10 most happening or occurring contradictions, is shirk or polytheism. And we have given this inshallah enough discussion in the last few weeks. Tonight we need to talk about the second one, which is taking other creatures as means of worshipping. Of course, this is part of the case of shirk, but it's given a special number because it is really more and more happening among Muslims. So we need really to discuss this point and see what is the mistake in here. What's the problem in here? To clarify this case, we will talk about two major cases. The first case is the case of Tawassul, which is the paper you have with you. And the second case, inshallah, later on we'll talk about it, maybe next week or the week after, the case of Shafa'a. These two cases are the gates to people to fall into the case of using other creatures to reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their worship. Yani using others as mediators to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their worship. And as you know, this is a spread thing happening among Muslims. It's not really a case that is happening by one or two people. It's happening by a lot of Muslims, unfortunately. So we need to understand it to save ourselves in the beginning and the first place, and also to do the mission of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in saving our Muslim brothers from falling into it. What do we mean by tawassul? This is a case which is really needed to be discussed, a case that a Muslim should really understand it clearly. We have a clear ayah or ayat on the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us about the case of tawassul. As the ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَابْتَغُوا إِلَيْهِ الْوَسِيلَةِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ.
So in this case Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted us to use wasila to reach him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the major ayah that a lot of Muslims are using to fall in the wrong way, thinking that that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them to use. So they think that the wasila here should be Muhammad Rasulullah himself, or his higher rank, or the pious people, the wali, awliya, as the means to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or wasila. The word wasila in Arabic is the noun, is the noun. And tawassul is the verb of it. So wasila could be how, if you ask yourself now, how did you come to the masjid? Somebody will say, my house is close from here, so I came walking. So he used his feet to come to the masjid. Some people are far away, so they use their cars. So their wasila to come to the masjid is their car. So wasila is something you are using to reach a goal. Wasila is something you use to reach the goal. So to reach the masjid, you use your car to reach in here because the place is far away. So your car is a wasila, an instrument used, or a means. And tawassul is the verb. Using this wasila is the tawassul. Let's come back to the case of what Allah Ta'ala told us in His holy book, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ مَنْ تَقُوا اللَّهَ وَابْتَهُوا إِلَيْهِ الْوَسِيلَةِ. Wasila actually, and tawassul is a wide case. Contains a lot of cases we can discuss and see, and a lot of permissible cases. But shaitan is smart. Although he is weak when it comes to the true mu'mins like you, inshaAllah. He is smart to make people leave all good wasila and use the wrong wasila to reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, thinking that they are obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he ordered them to use wasila. So, as you see in the paper we spread, we have explained that there are a lot of permissible tawassul ways to use. As Allah told us subhanahu wa ta'ala to use the wasila, so we have a lot of wasila to use. Yani, just an example, if your house is far away, how many wasila you can come with to the masjid? You can use your feet, you can use a motorcycle, you can use a car, you can use a taxi, whatever. So there's a lot of wasila to reach the masjid. Some of these wasila is not allowed. Like stealing a car to come to the masjid, to attend the dars. Although the goal is good, but the wasila is wrong. So we have to be careful in this case. We should use the allowed and halal wasila to reach the masjid for the dars or for salah or for anything else. To define tawassul, we should say tawassul is a use of a means. A use of a means. So, when we come to understand this, we say tawassul is not one type. Tawassul actually divided into two types. A permissible tawassul and non-permissible tawassul. A permissible tawassul, which is allowed and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes. And non-permissible tawassul is not allowed, could be bid'ah and could be also shirk. So we have to be careful when we talk about these two. Let's take it one by one to make it easy for us to understand and follow. The permissible tawassul can be divided into another two types. The first type is all worshipping that a Muslim do or does is a correct tawassul. So salah is a tawassul. Salah is a wasila. Zakah is a wasila. Sadaqah is a wasila. Wasila to what? To satisfy the Creator, sustainer, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he will accept you. He will accept your salah. He will accept your good deeds. He will be satisfied with you and he will get you into Jannah, inshaAllah. So, this wasila, all these worshippings we are doing is wasila, so he subhanahu wa ta'ala will be accepting these, he subhanahu wa ta'ala will be satisfied with us when we use this permissible wasila. Whatever you do, whatever the good deeds you do with these two conditions you remember we talked about, only for Allah, only the way of Rasulullah, this will be a fantastic wasila to satisfy the Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other type of permissible tawassul is a way to have your call responded. And this is to say with six classes. Yani you are using something to have your call, you are talking now about the call now, responded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Usually, if you want to ask Allah something, Ya Allah, give me this. Ya Allah, rizqni. Ya Allah, ghfirli. Ya Allah, rahamni. You can directly ask Allah without wasila, yes. But also you can use a good wasila to satisfy Allah Ta'ala so your call will be responded. Like what? Look at this, the first class of the six classes, which is A, by Allah, this name. How is that? You could do this by using one name of Allah. If you want to ask for rizq, so you say, Ya Razzaq, irzuqni. If you want to ask for mercy, Ya Rahman, irhamni. So you're using the name which is close to your need. If you want to be cured from sickness, Ya Shafi, ishfin. Ya Shafi, ishfin. And so on. So by one name, you can use any name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which is good for the thing you are going to ask for. The name of Allah, the beast names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are a fantastic wasila to satisfy Allah, so He will give you what you ask for. So you have your call responded by Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's done by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Another way to use the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the good names, the best names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a wasila, is also the way that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. By calling Allah by all the names of Him in one dua. How is that? As He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma inni as'aluka bi kulli ismin huwa lak. Sammayta bihi nafsak, wa anzaltahu fi kitabak, wa anlamta ahdam min khalq. Until the end of the hadith. So He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by all the names He has subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether we know it or not. That's what He say. That's why He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أسألك بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أو أنزلته في كتابك maybe if it's in your book أو علمته أحد من خلقك anybody, anyone of your creatures has known it you told him سبحانك وتعالى أو أبقيته في علم الغيب عندك علمته أحد من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك means that if you have kept this name nobody knows it I'm asking you by it also. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in this correct hadith, is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by every name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if we don't know it. So he is asking Allah by all the names in one dua, for anything he wants. And تجعل القرآن الكريم ربيع قلبي, to make Qur'an my heart leader, or whatever you call it. So put this in mind that using the names of Allah, the best names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the correct wasila also, one of the best wasila, which is permissible wasila to have your correspondent. And this is of course permissible wasila. As you will see inshallah, there is a lot of permissible wasila. We can use tawassul, we can use them for tawassul, and they are very limited wrong wasila or non-permissible wasila, while shaitan is directing Muslims to it. The second class of the wasila that you can have your dua accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and responded by Him subhanahu wa ta'ala is to use the qualifications of Allah. What's the difference between qualifications and names? There is a difference. A name is a name. So you can call Allah Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Alim, Al-Ghafur, and Allah has also descriptions or qualifications. So He is Alim. He is Rahman. He has Rahmah. He can see. He can hear. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are all qualifications of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in his hadith, A'udhu bi'izzatillah wa qudratihi mimma ajidu wa uhadir. So he makes ta'awud on the qudrah by the izzah of Allah. Izzah is a qualification of Allah. It's not a name. So we can use the qualification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for as a wasila to satisfy Him so He will answer our or respond to our call. Same thing also we can use one by one or use all in the same time as you said on the name. So this is another class, another way to use as a wasila to satisfy Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so our call will be responded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First one which is seen here is by your belief in Allah. From where we get this? From the last few ayahs in Surah Ali Imran. إن في اختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار. ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا. ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا. ليس الزكية ويريد. ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا. ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا. So because we have believed on you يا الله, that's the meaning of the ayat. Because we believed on you يا الله, please forgive us. So it's coming in the case that because of their belief, they're using their belief to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to request the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a permissible way. This is a permissible tawassul can be used by a Muslim. Ya Allah, because I believe in you, I believe in your Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Allah, give me this and this. So this is a permissible tawassul, which is to help to have your correspondence by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, another one is the presenting the state of the slave without asking. This is another good wasila to be used. So you respond, your call will be responded even if you did not call. From where we get this? We get this from the story of Musa alayhi salam. You remember Musa alayhi salam after he ran away from Fir'aun and his people after he killed one of the Egyptians. He ran away and he went to Madian. And in his way, he saw two ladies waiting for the men to drag the water for their cattle. But the two women cannot really push in with the people, so they waited until the people. So they asked them, "Why didn't you irrigate or take money, or take water for your cattle?" They said, "Well, I cannot because these are men." So he, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he was a strong person, he pushed in and he took water out from the wheel to these two ladies' cattle. Now after that, what did he do? He went to a shade and he sat under the shade and said, the meaning of that, Ya Allah, I am in need of your help or forgiveness and so on. He did not say anything. He just presented his state. Ya Allah, I am poor, I am needy, I need your help. That's it. He did not say give me or give me. No. He just showed his state. إني لما أنزلت إلي من خير فقير. And the same also happened to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم when he came back from Taif. After he called them for Islam and they answered him with a stupid and bad answer. And they made their children to throw him صلى الله عليه وسلم with rocks until his feet were bleeding. He came back to Mecca and in the way he passed by one of these valleys and he sat down to relax. And he made the dua to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala his state. So he used this dua as a wasila to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he will give him what he needs. So he presented sallallahu alayhi wa sallam his state in that area. One more also to say that we can use another wasila, which is a call of a person. And that happened, of course, in so many times in the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of these incidents was when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was making khutbah of Jumu'ah. One Bedouin, he came in and he said, Ya Rasulullah, yani he talked to Rasulullah while he was making the khutbah. That gives us an idea that Imam can talk to the Ma'mumin and vice versa also. But Ma'mumin cannot talk to each other. Yani we are attending the khutbah of Jumu'ah. We are not allowed to talk to the others. But it is allowed for us, if there's something necessary, we can talk to the Imam. However, this Bedouin came in and said, Ya Rasulullah, our cattle died and there's no water, we need water, call Allah for us. What did he do now? He's making wasila by calling for a person to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That was the best person, of course, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam directly raised his hand and he called for rain. Anas ibn Malik said, we were sitting in the masjid and there were no single piece of cloud in the sky. As soon as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam raised his hand and he requested Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for rain, clouds came in quickly. Before he finished his khutbah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his beard was wet with rain. صلى الله عليه وسلم. So what kind of tawassul did this Bedouin use? It's the call of a person, the best person of course, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Can we do the same thing? Yes, we can come and ask the good people like you to make dua for us, or dua for our children, or dua for something. But we have to be careful. There's two conditions in here, two problems also. First problem is that not to make it so much, so frequent. Because the person who is depending on the others to make dua for him, he will not make dua for himself. So every time he meets somebody, make dua for me, make dua for me, make. So he's asking everybody to make dua for him, he's not making dua for himself, which is very dangerous. Plus, if there's a pious person, a scholar or a good worshipper, and people are always coming to him, make dua for us, Shaitan will come to this worshipper, good worshipper, and say, oh, people are needing you, you know, you are a pious person, you are Khalandar Baba. So Shaitan will make him fall into the mistake, start to overestimate himself. So to make this once in a while, no problem. Yeah, to ask someone, good person, to make dua for us, that's fine. You ask your brother, your relatives, your good person, you know, your good person you know, for dua, that's fine. Once in a while, no problem. But not frequent. The last one on the classes of having your call responded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is by the pious deeds. You can ask Allah by your own pious deeds. And the evidence of this, the dalil, was the three cavemen. Mentioned by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his hadith that three cavemen left their town traveling, and at the night there was so much rain, so they looked around to find the cave to relax in until the rain is finished. And they got into a cave. As soon as they got into the cave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a big rock, closed the entrance of the cave. They tried to push it away, they couldn't. They were three, but this rock is pretty big. If they do not do anything, they will die like this, because it cannot be opened. So what they did, they said, why didn't we ask Allah by our pious deeds? So one of them asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he was very good with his parents. He said, Ya Allah, I used to be fantastic with my parents. One day I went for food, for other things, and when I came back so late, I used to milk my sheep to give my parents first, before my children. And one day I came late and my parents were already asleep. So I milked my sheep and kept the milk on my hand, waiting for them to wake up until Al-Fajr. I did not give my children. Ya Allah, listen to this. Ya Allah, if I have done this for you, leave this rock away. Remember this case. Ya Allah, if I have done this for you, leave this. So what kind of tawassul he used? He used his pious deeds to satisfy Allah, so Allah Ta'ala moved this rock. What happened? The rock moved a little bit. The rock moved a little bit, but they cannot lift out. So the other man said, Ya Allah, I used to have a relative, a lady relative. She was very good looking lady, and I always wanted her, not for zawaj, of course, not for marriage, for zina, na'udhu billah. She always refused. Until one year she was so poor, she cannot find food to eat. So she came to me and she said, give me some money, I want to live. And I refused. Unless she let me take her to bed. In the end, she had no other choice, so she went with me to bed. And when I came to the bed, she told me, اتق الله. Beware of Allah. Be fear of Allah. Have fear of Allah. Don't open the way without the right way. يعني without zawaj. So I left her and left the money. Fearing you, Ya Allah. If I have done this for you, Ya Allah, move this rock away from us. So the rock moved a little bit again. The third man said, Ya Allah, I used to have laborers working with me. And every time they finish, I give them their money. One day, one of them, he left without taking his money. I looked around for him, I couldn't find him. So I make his money into some sheep for him. And I still continuing to take care of these sheep until they became, mashallah, a lot. Years later, this laborer, this porter came to me, Ya Allah, and he wanted his money, so I gave him all the sheep that I have made for him. So many. And he got angry to me, he said, you are making fun of me. So I told him, Ya Allah, I told him, no, this is for you, I'm not making fun of you. These sheep all for you. So he took them all and he went away. Ya Allah, I have done this for you only. Move this rock away from us. The rock moved and they left out. What kind of tawassul did these people do? They used their good deeds, nobody knows about, to satisfy Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he will answer their call, and he did subhanahu wa ta'ala. So for us, if someone, one of us, he needs to make tawassul to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to use a wasila to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by one of his good deeds. Suppose one day you knew about a poor lady with children nobody knows about, so you went in the darkness and you gave her some food, and she doesn't know you, and nobody knew you about that, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then later on you needed to call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deeply and desperately, so you stood and say, Ya Allah, I have paid that money to that lady, or that food for that lady. Ya Allah, if I have done this for you only, give me this and this. This is a correct tawassul, and this is a correct wasila to use. So put this in mind, you can use this any time, and this is a permissible tawassul. These are six classes on the case of tawassul, we can use them to have our call responded. As you see now, how much is permissible tawassul we have? So much. So many ways to have permissible tawassul to Allah. So much wasila, allowed wasila, permissible wasila. But shaitan is smart. Still he wants people to use the non-permissible tawassul. How is that? He comes to us and says, you love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Of course we do. Do you think Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have a high rank with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Of course we do. We know that he is the best person ever walked on earth. And he is the Khalil of Ar-Rahman subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Khalil Ar-Rahman. Khalil means the more than love. Allah loves him more than ever. So he comes to say, okay, if he is Khalil Ar-Rahman and Allah loves him a lot, why didn't you ask Allah by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? By him personally, by himself, or by his high rank? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bi jahi Muhammad, as they say, or bi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or bi hubbi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, bi hubbika li Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What's the problem here? It's logically, if you think about it, we always give an example and say, if we have two brothers, Muhammad and Ali, Muhammad is a rich person, he is a millionaire, and Ali is a poor guy. If I go to Ali and say, Ya Ali, because Muhammad is a millionaire, give me 1,000 riyal. Is this logic? Is this logic? Is this because of this? Ali will tell me, go to Muhammad, he's the millionaire, not me. So if we come to the same case and say, why do we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Muhammad has a high rank, why do we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the high rank of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What's the connection in here? There's no connection between the high rank of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and with us. No connection with us in here. So the high rank of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is for him. And we are supposed to use the correct tawassul in this case. Just because Allah loves Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us what we want just because he has a high rank. Somebody will say, okay, we are a nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loves us. He loves us only if we are walking in the same way of him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he told us clearly how to use tawassul. So we are supposed to use the tawassul the way he told us to do. When we start to use things that he did not allow us to do, then he does not like us anymore. As he told us, عَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّةِ وَسُنَّةِ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِيِّينَ مِنْ بَعْدِي تَمَسَّكُوا بِهَا تَمَسَّكُوا بِهَا وَعَضُّوا عَلَيْهَا مِنْ نَوَاجِذِ وَإِيَّاكُمْ Beware of وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحْدَثَاتِ الْأُمُورِ فَإِنَّ كُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ Every novelty in the deen of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is rejected and refused. That is ضلال, it is curving away from Islam. Did he tell us to use his high rank to make it as a tawassul? Give me hadith. You cannot find one single hadith that goes, use my high rank to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make tawassul to him or wasila. No way. So we are supposed in our worshipping to use only the correct way that Muhammad Hassan told us to do. Remember we said, and we also repeated, always repeat that to have our deeds accepted, they have to be in two conditions. There must be two conditions applied. Only for Allah, only the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If not, don't make so much effort. If a person is doing some good deed not for Allah, he is a hypocrite. In fact, if you remember the hypocrites in the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul and the others, they were doing more than any Muslim now is doing. They are praying with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are fasting with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are making jihad with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Still they are in the bottom level of hellfire. إن المنافقين في الدرك الأسفل من النار. Why? Because they were not doing this for Allah, only to show the others, only to save their blood from being killed by Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And if we miss the other condition, and if this the good deed we are doing is only for Allah, but it's not the way of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, this is becoming a novelty. And Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم clearly told us, من عمل عملا ليس عليه أمرنا فهو رد. Any good deed has done not the way of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is rejected upon this hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. So we have to be careful not to think only about being sincere for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our deed, also to know how to do it only for Allah and only the way of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. So if someone comes to you and tell you, okay, why didn't you do such and such good deed, ask him. Of course you know yourself this will, you will do it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but ask him, do you have evidence to do this? Did Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us to do it? Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us to do it? If yes, alhamdulillah, we'll do it. If no, then we'll say, why are we doing it then? If Rasulullah did not tell us to do it, why are we doing it? As an example, we just maybe yesterday, some Muslims, they made a celebration of the birthday of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Milad or Mawlid. If you ask him, why you do this? They say, wallahi, we love Allah, we love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so we do Mawlid for him. Fine, I know you are sincere in that. Most Muslims are sincere in this case. I'm not saying anything. Truly, yes, they are sincere of love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are sincere of making Milad for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because they love Allah and love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But ask him the second question. Is this action you are doing ordered by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Is this action done by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Is this action done by Abu Bakr or Umar or Uthman or Ali رضي الله عنهم وارضاهم? No. So this is bid'ah or novelty then. It is not allowed to do it because, why are not, we are not allowed to do it? Because Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم did not do it. And he did not told us to do it. And Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali, the four Khalifa, did not do it. So we are not supposed to do it. This is just an example. The Milad case is not only an example, but there's a lot of other bid'ahs. Maybe we'll talk about them later on inshaAllah. Like we said, the case of pronouncing the intention of Salah before Salah. When a person starts to make Salah and he starts to say, Allahumma inni nawaitu an usalli, he's pronouncing his attention that I'll pray, Ya Allah, I'm having the attention to pray Al-Isha after such and such Imam in such and such Masjid in Riyadh in Saudi Arabia and such and such. Ishar. From where is this? But if we ask this person three questions. We'll ask him, whom are you telling now? Are you telling Allah? Astaghfirullah. Allah knows everything, without even if you say it. The second question we'll ask him, are you telling yourself? Allah, if he's telling himself, it means he's not okay. The person is not okay. He is not in his mind, actually. The third question, are you telling someone around you? This is show off or riyah. Why are you telling the others that you will pray? Khalas. Again, if you ask yourself this question, when you leave your house to the masjid for Salat al-Isha, if someone stabs you and say, where are you going? Are you going to think, Allah, maybe, let me think, where am I going? No need for this. Directly you tell him, I'm going for Al-Isha Salah. I'm going to the masjid for Al-Isha Salah. Khalas, your niyyah is already there. Since you went for wudu to go for Al-Isha Salah, you have already the niyyah in your mind. So no need to pronounce it or say it or keep it or so on. Yes, you keep this, you don't stop it truly, but you don't say it, you don't pronounce it. There's some other novels we'll talk about them inshallah later on when we have the chance. The case of tawassul, just to finalize our topic tonight, is a permissible tawassul is so wide. So many allowed wasila can be used. So many. And the wrong wasila, non-permissible tawassul is very limited. But shaitan will drag Muslims to use the non-permissible instead of the permissible. They go to these graves and say, we are using these graves to be our mediators to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because we are humble and so on. We have given the example before we talk about it. They try to use something easier for them, as they say, instead of making so much ibadah, they just go to such and such grave for a very good person and say, Ya Allah, because of this person is beloved by you, Ya Allah, give me this and this. We said there's no connection in here. Whether he's Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or a pious person who died long time ago and so on. So while we go and find out these things which is not allowed and leave the much wasail or wasila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed us to do, because shaitan wants to drag people to shirk. Tawassul is one of the biggest gates to shirk, polytheism, because shaitan brings people from the correct thing to the wrong thing by playing a game in that. Say, didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell you to use wasila? Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullaha wa abtaghu ilayhi alwasila. You will say, of course. Say, why don't you use the best wasila, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself or his high rank? No, this is not the best wasila. A person may come and say, what about Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu? He made tawassul of Al-Abbas ibn Abd al-Muttalib radiallahu anhu. When they did not have rain for some time, Umar ibn Khattab went with Al-Abbas and other Sahaba and said, and he requested Allah by Al-Abbas to give them rain. Is this true? No. Wrong in here, because Umar radiallahu anhu arda Umar ibn Khattab did not ask Allah by Al-Abbas. If you read the hadith clearly and carefully, you will see that Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, as the Abu Dawood said in his Sunan, you will find that Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu said, Ya Allah, the day before he said, Ya Allah, we used to ask you by the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to give us rain. And now, yani because Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam already did, we are asking you by the dua of Al-Abbas. So what kind of tawassul he used? Call of a person. We said this is allowed. In fact, in Abu Dawood, Sunan Abu Dawood, he said, قم يا عباس ادعو الله لنا. Stand up عباس, call Allah for us. Why do you ask العباس specially? Because he's the uncle of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and he's one of the Ahlul Bayt. And Ahlul Bayt have extra and more than regular Muslims. They have extra rights. Because they are the house of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, the people of the house of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. So he wanted to ask Allah by the dua of العباس, by the call of a person. That was Al-Abbas رضي الله عنه, not by Al-Abbas himself. There are so many also wrong understanding of other hadith. We don't want to go for on for it because this will take us so long time, but I just gave you this, an example of the case of Al-Abbas. When you ask these people who ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى by the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم himself or by his high rank, they will tell you Umar ibn Khattab asked Allah by Al-Abbas. No, not true. Not true at all. Because Umar رضي الله عنه did not ask Allah by Al-Abbas himself. He asked Al-Abbas to call Allah for them. And Al-Abbas, he stood and he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then they had rain. So this is a permissible tawassul, which we said it is a permissible tawassul by a call of a person. Also Mu'ayyah ibn Abi Sufyan radiallahu anhu did almost the same thing with one of the good tabi'een called Al-Jurashi. He was a fantastic worshipper and he called him and said, make dua for us for rain. And he did, because the good people, you can ask them for dua. especially if this is for all Muslims like rain and so on. But we ask Allah by them, or we ask them to ask Allah for us. This is the correct way. Not to ask Allah by them. Ya Allah, because Muhammad is beloved to you, give us this. No connection in here. But we can say, Ya Allah, Ya Fulan, call Allah for us. Then he will call Allah for us. Then this is a request by a person, or the tawassul by a call of a person. I think this is clearing the case of tawassul, inshallah. And next week, inshallah, hopefully we'll talk about the case of shafa'ah, because it's also the same topic to explain, inshallah, more and more. And if you have any questions, go ahead. Yes, sir.
When you make tawassul between your good and five deeds, and Allah,
what,
you lose the reward of the
reward? No, you don't lose the reward. The good deed is a good deed, but this is another good deed you are doing by using your good deed. Yes. Any questions, brothers? Yes. Salam.
What do you use these deeds?
Yes, as Arif said, it's still counted, it's still there. This is extra or another good deed also you're doing. Yani this tawassul itself is another deed. That good deed has already counted. Yani you will not lose it, inshallah. Yes, Arif.
Isn't that like the people who celebrate the Prophet's birthday, you think like most of them are sincere, but in reality they're not. Most of them don't pray and stuff like that.
We cannot say so, because we don't know what's in their heart. So we take Muslims as the best way. Yani, if someone comes and does something and he says, no, I meant this, you cannot say, no, you didn't mean this. How did I know? Because I did not see his heart. Same thing that happened to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with Usama ibn Zayd when he killed the kafir. After he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Muhammad Rasulullah. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got angry to him. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, Usama ibn Zayd said, Ya Rasulullah, he said it just to run away from being killed. He said, did you open his heart? The meaning of this. هَلَّا شَقَقْتَ عَنْ قَلْبِهِ. Did you open his heart and see that he means it? So the case of intentions, we didn't know. We cannot judge. We will judge only on the what they are doing. But we come to the case and say, and the other condition, which is this the way of Rasulullah? It is not, so we will not do it. Maybe there are some of them are not sincere. They want only to enjoy or have food or have party or maybe have bad things and so on. جزاكم الله خير. We'll see you inshallah next week. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.